Namaskar students, we will continue with chapter number 10, more on fractions, part number 5, page number 80 and 81, exercise 10A. All of you take out your junior maths book 4 and open at page number 81st. You can see I have written on the board, to get an equivalent fraction, we multiply or divide the numerator and the denominator by the same number. Again I have written this one. Because you have to remember this, otherwise you will not be able to do. Number 3, fill in the blanks. In our previous class, we also have done fill in the blanks. Here 3e, I have written the sum. 6 by 18. This is the number and we have to find out the equivalent fractions. First one, it is written 6 by 18. Denominator is divided by 2. Denominator 18 is divided by, sorry. Denominator 18 is multiplied by 2. So we have to multiply the numerator also by 2. Clear? Now as it will be multiplied or divided by the same number. Next one, 6 divided by, you have to write this one. Okay, numerator, numerator's place. And here also 18 divided by, it is written denominator 18 is divided by 3. So we have to multiply, divide the numerator by 3, same number. 6 by 18, next one. Here the numerator 6 is divided by 2. So the denominator 18 will also be divided by 2. Same number, you can see. Multiplied by 2, divided by 3 and divided by 2. Clear? I hope that now you have understood. I am rubbing this one and we will go to sum number 4. What is there in sum number 4? Write the equivalent fractions with denominator 30. Clear? 4a, 3 by 10, then 5th denominator 30, that means you have to write 30 as denominator. Here the denominator is 10 and here it is 30. The same old formula, if we divide 30 by 10, 10 threes are 30, that means if we multiply 10 by 3, we get 30. That means denominator 10 will be multiplied by 3 to get 30. So numerator 3 also will be multiplied by 3. That means your answer will be 9 by 30. Clear? In this way you have to find out the equivalent fraction with denominator 30. That is sum number 4, all the sums. Now, sum number 5. Write the equivalent fraction with numerator 36. 5B I am doing. 3 by 4. Here it is said with numerator 36. So you have to find out the denominator over here. Before, denominator was given, we had to find out the numerator. Here, numerator is given and we have to find out the denominator. 36 and 3. 36 will be divided by 3. 3 twelves are 36. That means, if we multiply 3 by 12, we get 36. Okay? So, here also, what we have to do? We have to multiply the denominator 4 by 12. That means, 36 by 48. This will be your answer. Clear? Now, we will go to, I am rubbing the whole we will go to sum number 6. That is page number. Now you go to page number 81. 6. Use multiplication to write two equivalent fractions of. Use equivalent fractions of 6a. Here it is said use multiplication. 3 by 7. We have to do the multiplication. So we will start with the smaller number 2. We cannot get 1, as if we multiply 3 by 1, the result comes as same. So we will not take 1, we will start with 2. So 3 into 2, numerator 2, and denominator will also be multiplied by 2. Your answer comes as 6 by 14. This is number 1. Here it is said 2 equivalent fractions. This is number 1. Then what we will do? Next number, after 2 comes 3. So numerator 3 will be multiplied by 3 and denominator 7 also will be multiplied by 3. Result comes as 9 by 21. So your first answer is 6 by 14 and the second answer is 9 by 21. This thing I have done to make you understand. This you won't have to write in the book. You will have to write the answer. 6 by 14 and 9 by 21. Clear? Now I am writing this one. Sum number 7. Use division. To write two equivalent fractions. Two equivalent fractions of 7a. It is given 12 by 18. So we have to do now division. What we have to do? We have to divide the numerator as well as the denominator by the same number. We will start with the smaller number 2. Okay, if 12, the numerator, and the 18, the denominator is divisible by 2? Yes, because both the numbers are even numbers. Should be divisible by 2. So, 12 divided by 2 as well as 18 divided by 2. So if we divide 12 by 2, the result comes as 6. And if we divide 18 by 2, the result comes as 9. So this is your first answer, 6 by 9. Clear? Now, two equivalent fractions using division. So we will get to another number. Next number, is done. Then we will go for 3. If 12 and 18, numerator and the denominator, these two numbers are divisible by 3. Are these two numbers in 3's table? Yes. 12 is divisible by 3 as well as 18 is also divisible by 3. So 12 divided by 3 and 18 divided by 3. If we divide 12 by 3, the result comes as 4. And if we divide 18 by 3, the result comes as 6. So, your answer is 4 by 6. So, two equivalent fractions of 12 by 18 using division are 6 by 9 and 4 by 6. Clear? I hope that you have understood. If here the number both the denominator, numerator and the denominator, if it would not be divisible by 3, then we would try for 4. If it is not divisible by 4, then we would have to try for 5. This way we have to check and then write. So students, now I will give you the work to do. Exercise 10A, 4, BCD, 5, ACD, 6, BCD, and 7, also BCD. Clear? I hope that you have understood. To find out an equivalent fraction, we have to multiply or divide both the numerator and the denominator by the same number. These things only you have to remember. If you remember these and if you learn the tables properly, then it would be very easier for you to do. So students, today up to this much. In our next class, we shall meet again. Till then, Namaste my students.